Now you'll find out how to see a bright comet, a position of Jupiter that will make this gas giant look bigger and brighter, and planetary conjunctions that will ensure that finding Saturn and other planets is actually pretty easy in November 2023. I promise, will be very interesting. November starts with the opposition of Jupiter, which brings the planet to the opposite side of the Sun in the sky as seen from Earth. Thus, Jupiter will be visible all night long while rising in the east after sunset and setting in the west before sunrise. Because Jupiter is at its closest approach to Earth during opposition, it becomes brighter and larger through telescopes. I made a separate video where I explored this event in more detail, so link in the description. Expect to see something like this through small telescopes. On November 9th, our natural satellite passes really close to Venus. This extremely bright couple rises late and becomes visible in the east until sunset. These two are the brightest celestial bodies visible at night, so you won't miss them at all. The cherry on top of this event would be the lunar occultation of Venus, visible during the morning and day in Greenland, Europe, and Northern Africa. Now, let's explore the most exciting astronomical event. On November 10th and 11th, Comet C2023 H2 Lemmon will pass at only 30 million kilometers from Earth, reaching a fairly bright apparent magnitude and offering a spectacular viewing opportunity with its rapid velocity, visible even through small telescopes and binoculars. In order to find out the current location of the comet, refer to an amazing resource called theskylife.com.
Link in the description.
After following the link, you'll find an online night sky map with the current location of the comet. It's that simple. Yet another opposition comes in November, the opposition of Uranus. This event happens approximately once a year, so utilize this chance to observe the planet's blue-green color and potentially the moon's if your telescope is big enough. Yes, to observe Uranus, a telescope or a pair of binoculars is needed, as it remains much dimmer than the naked eye planets. Uranus can be found pretty high in the sky all night long, which, just like Jupiter, rises in the east after sunset and sets in the west before sunrise. Expect to see something like this through small telescopes. The next few days of November bring the peak of the Leonids meteor shower, an annual event that occurs in November and December, as Earth passes through debris from a pretty large comet. During the peak on November 17th and 18th, it produces up to 15 meteors per hour that can be seen traveling at speeds of up to 44 miles per second. The moon will fortunately descend beneath the horizon shortly after sunset, so it won't impair your observations. On November 20th, the moon will come close to the sixth planet from the sun, Saturn. Conjunctions are great chances for new sky watchers to find two cool celestial bodies at the same time. Saturn with its alluring rings and the moon with its secret alien bases. This couple is visible in the southern part of the sky a few hours after sunset. Expect to see something like this through small telescopes. 4 days later, the moon will pass close to another gas giant in our solar system, Jupiter. Taking into account its current proximity to our planet, observing Jupiter and the moon at the same time provides a great opportunity for planetary observation enjoyers. The moon will follow the largest planet in the solar system all night long, appearing early after sunset and setting soon before sunrise. Finally, the month of November concludes with the full Beaver Moon that will illuminate the night skies on our planet on November 27th. The moon won't change its appearance in any way. It'll be your regular full moon. So why is it called the Beaver Moon? Well, it's because this is when beavers start hunkering down in their homes after gathering enough food for the upcoming winter. Back in the old days of fur trading in North America, it was also the time when people would catch beavers for their warm, winter-ready fur. So now you can do whatever you want with this information. In addition, November 2023 will mark a great month to observe planets. With the exception of Mercury, which is located very low above the southwestern horizon, and Mars, which isn't visible at all, other celestial bodies will be shining brightly, or almost brightly, in the sky. November also features very bright deep sky objects, Andromeda Galaxy perfectly visible in the northern hemisphere, and Orion Nebula visible in the southern part of our planet. Both can be literally seen with the unaided eye in areas with medium-level light pollution. Two additional objects can be easily found in the November sky, Messier 92 and Messier 33. Now, you know how to stay busy at night, right? Get away from city lights to enjoy the beauty of deep sky objects, as light pollution can be a buzzkill. In any case, remember to subscribe to this channel to see more future videos on space and astronomy. And as always, thank you for watching very interesting videos. Bye.